Texas A&M is going to wrap up the SEC West. Jimbo Fisher finally got the ball rolling last year, went 9-1. Now, did they run from Ole Miss at the end of the season?
No.
I'm just messing
around. Everybody had COVID problems, and not one person said they ran from them.
I know. The win total for Texas A&M this year is 9.5. To go over is minus 115. To go under is minus 115.
That is a 10-2
yep.
record.
Yep. And I feel pretty good about it. Season's going to come down to this quarterback battle. Haynes King, like, he's got 4-5 speed, but, you know, the other guy, Zach Calzada, I mean, he's so much more accurate with the ball. He's a better passer. He's got a perfect deep ball, man. I don't know what they're going to end up doing. It depends on what Jimbo wants to run with. If he's looking for more out of the passing game, it's going to be Calzada. If he wants the dual threat option, it's going to be Haynes King. I don't know which way it goes. King was the backup last season for Kellen Mond. Offensive line loses 4 out of 5, but, man, like, they got their best one back. That's Kenyon Green. And the Aggies have always been able to develop offensive line.
I was about to say, they're just going to roll in four new guys that, A, are not freshmen. They've been on this team. They know this scheme.
Yes.
They know this blocking scheme. They know how to work together as an offensive line. I think their offensive line is going to be fine.
Tight end, Jalen Watermeyer.
Going to be really good.
Going to be really good. Wide receiver room. Not going to load on, you won't know a ton of those names
yet,
but they have got dudes now. They got speed now. They got all kind of stuff. Isaiah Spiller back at running back. Like, offense is going to be just fine.
I think the offense is going to be fine.
Also, you know how much love I have in my heart for Mike Elko.
Yep.
That defense,
best defensive coordinator in the conference.
They've got legit horses on the defensive line. They have got all kind of players. Like, their recruiting has been really, really good. They got players everywhere. And I trust Mike Elko no matter what is going on. I think that he will be able to stop teams. So, with that said, I'm going over the 9.5.
I am too.
I think they're going to get to 10. Like, I think it is much more likely they do 10 as opposed to 9.
If this team finished 11-1, it wouldn't shock me.
Wouldn't shock me either. I could see them winning the SEC West this year.
I could see them.
Like, if they were going to do it, this, I feel like this would be the year. You know? Like,
it's hard to say because they're starting an unproven quarterback.
Agreed.
So, that's a tough expectation. But it just wouldn't surprise me because I think Jimbo's been building to this for a long time. He also, remember, won his national championship with a true freshman with quarterback.
Yes. I don't know that Haynes King or Zach Calzada are going to be Jameis Winston, but...
Hang on. You don't know that they're not.
Exactly.
All right? Was Jameis Winston anything special, or was he a product of Jimbo Fisher?
He was a redshirt freshman.
Because Jimbo Fisher in the league... He pretty much just throws the ball up in the air, and if his guys come down with it, great. And if the other guys come down with it, great. He doesn't care.
You're right.
He didn't do that at Florida State.
No, you're so right about that. So right about that. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter, at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com, or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.